Halo Fanatics. So school has started. Justice. The smell of fear, anticipation, and freshly bought markers, notebooks, and other stuff, manila folders and everything from Staples. By the way, what is the school shopping? Okay, I don't think there was school shopping in Soviet Russia. Like, my parents never went school shopping. Sure, you bought a couple of notebooks for the little genius, and I still had my pen from last year. It's not like I used up all the pen. It's not like I'm Lev Tolstoy, you know, who wrote up pages and pages of stuff. No, you had a pen and paper and you were ready for school. But no, here in America, they showed me the least sheet of paper with like what to buy. Seriously, like I this is like more stuff than I've had in my life. 93 3-hole punchers, 39 2-hole punchers, 200 one-hole punchers, I don't know, like vanilla folders, manila folders, strawberry folders. What else? Like 11 kinds of pens, ideally an iPad. An iPad? Do they know how much an iPad costs? It's like $600. I don't have an iPad. And my seventh grader is supposed to have it. They said it's a nice to have. But our friends have child in private school. They have to have a laptop. I mean, it's just unbelievable. But anyhow, so school is starting. Children, I actually feel for you. I understand. I think it's a God-given right to have a couple of months off in the summer. It was 3 months in Russia, by the way. There was none of the snow days. Oh, there you go. Okay, we complain about Russia, but this is something they do right. Russia does summer vacation right. May 31st. Win, lose, or draw, whether it rained or whether it was earthquakes or anything or snows, school is out. Okay, vacation starts. September 1st, school begins. 3 months. None of this, like, well, children, we had 2 snow days and therefore we're adding 2 weeks. And in June, they're like, I don't know, they're watching movies and video games. Ridiculous. Anyhow, I'm glad that you took time off. But now, back to school. Crazy Russian dad loves school. Love homework, maths, and practicing instrument. You need to do all of those things, okay? But I understand it's a confusing time. Like, you come back, you don't know what to expect. You may be the whole new school. Like, my younger boy goes to a whole new school. Okay, he's nervous, okay? Like, he's been putting his new notebooks in piles and alphabetizing them and all of that. Sure sign of the fact that he's probably nervous. So I told him, like, listen, everybody comes new to this new school. Please relax. But I understand, like, some children come back and they're like, they've grown a foot. And some come back, they didn't grow a foot. So all of a sudden, you may be one of them and you're looking from downstairs or from upstairs on somebody. It's certainly confusing. Your bodies are changing. So mine's certainly changing. I'm getting wider. Confusing time, but also exciting time. Like, going back to school can be fun. Just don't look too much at everybody else. Do your own thing. I think that's a spiritual quality, I think. Don't look at what other children wear and what kind of shoes they wear. Your parents cannot afford to buy it anyway. At least I cannot afford to buy it. I told my children early on, okay, sure you can buy new shoes as long as they're from like Walmart or Target, okay? I mean, Russian immigrants cannot buy the, if it starts with a one, okay? Unless it's a 2-digit number. I cannot buy it. I told my children, they understand. So be like my children. Don't expect fancy gifts and fancy clothes, okay? Walmart is where we buy clothes, sometimes Marshalls. But Marshalls, you don't always get the right size, so it looks kind of ridiculous. I digress. Forget about the clothes. Good luck in this coming year, children, and good luck to you parents as well. We have to do it for one more year. Do your homework, practice your instrument, and above all, listen to your parents. Good night.